When we say Islam, we talk about Muhammad. Muhammad said, whole earth is a mosque for me. Can you make a more inclusive statement than that? Please let the Muslims live by that. When we say Hindus, now they're talking about Ram. Rama is that kind of man, just to… out of his integrity, he gives up his kingdom. He's a coronated king, but he walks away into the forest and his wife is stolen, terrible things are done. But when he kills his enemy who stole his wife and did terrible things to the people, he repents having killed him. So that is the man you're fighting for, don't forget. And for the leftist, let them remember all this conniving nonsense that they're doing everywhere. Even today they're continuing like this. I want to remind them, they are not progeny of Joseph Stalin or Mao Zedong. They are supposed to represent Karl Marx, who thought of an equitable society, a society without, you know, disparities, a compassionate economy which will nurture every human being. This is what he represents. Please let all three remember this. Right now this fanning of Hindu Muslims must fight, this whole thing is unfortunately not coming from Islamic community or largely from Hindu community. There are fringe elements on both sides, I'm not saying no. But largely it is coming from left-leaning extremists. What is their interest in religion? They should not even be interested in religion. But they are always playing with this. I request all of them, please understand whom you represent. You represent Muhammad, you cannot do this. If you represent Ram, you cannot do this. If you represent Karl Marx, you cannot do this.
So left-leaning extremists. Now the Prime Minister has come up with a term to describe some of them. He says that they have occupied a vast influence over the minds of this country because they are located very close to the center of power. I mean, you can call it the Latian zone, you can call it the Khan market consensus, what have you. But do you believe these individuals have a motivated interest, or are they just ideologically driven to doing this?
See, that is what I said. Their ideology is about Karl Marx. They are motivated because unfortunately, they have understood this. When Marx envisioned communism, he thought richest nations will go for communism because he believed out of our humanity we will become communist. But right now, they have understood only if there is poverty, there will be communism. To convert people into communism, you need endemic poverty in this nation. So they are working towards that. They must be defeated because this is not good for the country. The country is striving to progress. People are striving to fulfill their aspirations, and some people, their aspiration is in based in poverty as a capital.
Very interesting, very eye-opening and interesting. Sadhguru, I want to ask you that inevitably in a court case there will be one winner and loser.
I'm telling you, yeah. they're
Yes. No, go ahead. You were saying something. Go ahead.
No, I'm telling you how far this goes means this is not just about temple and mosque. These same people are going about campaigning. If you plant lot of trees, it's dangerous for the country. How do you… what do you say about that?
Very interesting.